seen public metrology for a project unless I would fold dew from the ground and heavenly water from above. So it's quite fitting, actually, that on this day we actually do have rain, in the sense that God is answering our blessings and our prayers before we've even sent them. And so I hope that that is a sign for both of you and your marriage together in the future, that God will always be able to sort of predict the blessings that we might need in your life as he has today. So today we are going to have really two ceremonies. We both have Seder Erusin and Seder Nisuin, two essential parts of what it means to get married as a Jewish couple. Typically, these were done, or traditionally, a long time ago, they were actually done with a great span of time in between, sometimes even months, or up to a year would pass in between one and the other. The first one is the betrothal, or we might call it engagement. The second is the actual marriage. So the rabbis, in their wisdom, decided it would probably be better if we put these two things right up against each other. So I know you've been engaged for quite some time planning this wedding. I was engaged for a while, so I understand. But the actual Jewish engagement will last approximately 15 minutes. So enjoy all of us. And each of the sections of the wedding ceremony uses, of course, a cup of wine that you sanctify the moment. So you have two beautiful Kiddush cups here that we will use. I'm going to lead us to the first ceremony. Each of you will take a drink. And the second ceremony, you give me the honor to many of your friends and family. Repeat these words after me, and we shall recite it as well in English, and then we will be saved. from them now retelling of these foundational narratives of Judaism. But these lesser-known narratives offer a particularly valuable lesson to be shared at the celebration of a new marriage. These wells provided water and sustenance to our ancestors, to their families, and to their communities. Abraham digs three wells in his day, but his enemies fill them in with earth, thus nullifying their benefit. His son Isaac redigs those same three wells, and then digs an additional three. And finally, in Parshat Toldot, which we read just yesterday in Torah, Isaac's servants built one final well, the seventh well, after which they come to him and they say to him, Matsanu Mayim, we have found water. A well, like a marriage, is a continuous source of blessing, bracha. Like a properly built and well-constructed well, the relationship between a husband and a wife, between you, Jeff, and you, Leah, is an endless source of blessing, not only for the two of you, but for your family and friends as well. And although I have not personally dug a well on my own, I imagine that to dig one requires hard work and a bit of trial and error to find the right place to construct it. Similarly, the relationship between a husband and a wife does not materialize from nothing, but requires a great deal of hard work, and I can attest also has its own fair share of trials and errors. But those moments of difficulty, and I hope that they are indeed few and far between, are and will be a part of the building of your relationship, the digging and the construction of your very own well of bracha, your own well of blessing. Earlier in your relationship, you faced one of these difficulties, and you, Jeff, were working it on your own, the place where the two of you met. Actually, I think it's a place where the three of us met. While you, Leah, were living and working a few hours south in Atlanta. That distance was not ideal, but together you found and made a way to make it work. And through that hard work, you came to learn just how much you value and love each other. Jeff, you would wake up extra early on your day off to drive from the mountains of Raven County down to see Leah in Atlanta for just a few short hours before Leah, you had to go to work yourself. Separately, you've each emphasized to me how your memories of that summer were actually the very ones that proved to you that you had each found the one. But the couple hours car ride from Clayton to Atlanta was not even the greatest separation that you faced. Jeff, you traveled many times from Florida to visit Leah at Brightless, and you even went to see her as she was studying abroad in Europe. Together, you have found ways to surmount all of these challenges, and that too will be a blessing for your marriage. That whenever life's difficulties arise, you'll face them together, emboldening and strengthening upon each other. In our tradition, the well has a particular significance as well. It's not only the source of blessing and well-being, but it reappears time and again in our narratives as the location of momentous events. Abraham's servant finds Rebecca at a well, and she demonstrates great righteousness, and she becomes Isaac's wife, the mother of Jacob. Moses demonstrates his bravery and his sense of humanity at a well when cruel shepherds prohibit Zipporah and her family from accessing its water. The two of you have wells in your relationship too, important places that brought you closer together and helped you to fall in love. Ramat Haron is one of those wells, the place where you met and befriended each other. It's also the place where you, Jeff, came to know his parents, It was there in Boca that you two truly became close with one another. In a sense, Jeff, you had already surmounted the greatest challenge without ever knowing where this could all go. You got the chance to spend more time with Leah's family, building a relationship with not only her but her siblings, even before you started dating. And Leah told me that for her, this was quite meaningful, for she knew that you also valued your family and friends, and that together that value will guide your relationship in the years to come. In addition to your mutual adoration for your family, you both demonstrate a unique dedication to the Jewish people, instilled within you by your parents, by your education, and I hope by your lifelong commitment to Ramah. And still today, you're both intimately involved in the Jewish community. Leah works for the AJC, and Jeff works for Act 36. This commitment to your families, to Judaism, to each other, is like water drawn from the depths of a well. It serves not only as the foundation of your relationship, but it will also sustain and nurture it in the years to come. Returning for a moment to that narrative in Parshat Toldot, Isaac's servants exclaim after the digging of the seventh well, "Matsanu mayim," we found water. This notion, finding the very thing for which you've been searching, is echoed by the phrase you included on your wedding invitation, "Matsati et shavah nafshi," I have found the one whom my soul desires. Just as the number seven in our tradition signifies completion, in totality, like the seventh day of creation, the seventh day of the week, which we observe as Shabbat, the seventh well was finally the one, filled with endlessly flowing water, with endless blessing and love. Now that you two have found each other and have solidified your relationship, Nisuin and Kiddushin here below the Kippah today, you two have a sense of wholeness, fullness, and completion. My prayer and blessing for the two of you is that this sense of shleimut, of wholeness, a blessing of love, will be what allows you to turn towards and count on each other during both the great times and perhaps even the difficult ones. It will inspire you to eventually bring into the world new friends, in addition to Cooper, which is the name of the dog. And it will be the ever-present source of strength, love, and passion that you two have brought to this very moment, into this relationship. So I hope that today is the happiest of days of your lives that you've had thus far, but that all the days that you have in the future will be as happy, if not happier, than today. Now I'll have an opportunity as well to read the very beginning and the end of our Ketubah, if you did not see it before. Everyone can see the beautiful Ketubah with the Hebrew name, Rachel, Tubia, the Leah Chana written above.